long as we got each other. We got the world spinning right in our hands, baby, you and me. We gotta be the luckiest dreamers who never quit dreaming. As long as we keep on giving, we can take anything that comes out.
Episode of The Millennial and
The other
generation. Today we're here to talk to you guys about Halloween because it's coming up right around the corner. And Shawn and I wanted to have a conversation about what my Halloween was like as a kid versus what his Halloween was like as a kid, because I think there's some pretty stark differences that we've noticed just in talking in person. So we'll go ahead and get right into it. Shawn, my first question was with costumes. I feel like every kid thinks about their Halloween costume for sometimes weeks or months in advance until the big day. So what were some of the popular costumes when you were a kid, and how did people go about getting their costumes and stuff?
Yeah, no doubt about it. It was definitely, a well thought process. And my mother was a sewer of sorts, and family members were. So it was always homemade, definitely a homemade costume. And there was a lot of work that went into it. I think probably more of what we had was like general themes of like a policeman, a football player, a general kind of theme versus kind of a character.
Sure.
So I think that, you know, ours may have been a little different as, you know, we got older. There was more play on characters and TV personalities and things. But typically as we were little, it was always based around very generic figures.
Yeah. Yeah, for me, I feel like it was kind of opposite. So I know there were plenty of people that still made their costumes, but my parents always just kind of took my sister and I to, you know, whatever Halloween store popped up that year right by our house. And we would just look and we'd pick one to dress up as. And there was a lot of very specific costumes. So it was, you know, Power Rangers were really big for a while, or the Scream
Ninja Turtles
Ninja Turtles. And I feel like there was so many years, there was always a guy that would dress up with the Scream mask, and some of them would have like the blood that rushed through the mask. And it was very, I feel, character forward when I was a kid compared to, like you said, I mean, sure, there were people that were still just police officers or football players, but it was very also much pop culture people started coming into the costumes that we would have.
I would say when I was younger, it was more, again, themed around those generic figures, but less ghouls and goblins. You know, there was a generic witch thrown in there. There was, but not any like the Saw characters, you know, characters off of like the crazy movies now where they're
the creepy masks and
blood everywhere. I think that that has become a little bit more popular.
Absolutely.
For years.
Yeah. So I have to ask, because every kid obviously goes trick-or-treating to get the goods. We want the candy. So what were some of the popular candies, or what was your favorite candy or treat that you would get when trick-or-treating?
Well, I would say Mrs. Brine's popcorn balls were great. But that's a huge difference, I would say. Probably we had families that would make treats, apples, popcorn balls, various homemade goods and things like that, which I know is you know, frowned upon now hugely because of the risks and so associated with it. But you know, Bit of Honey was a big one. That was my favorite. Laffy Taffy, of course.
Sure.
Jolly Ranchers. You know, things
like
that.
Yeah. I mean, I remember when I was trick-or-treating, we weren't allowed to eat the homemade candies. That kind of was the phase when people would potentially put risky things in a homemade candy. So my parents always told me, if you got one, you have to throw it away when you get home. You're not allowed to eat it because it was dangerous. So we would always, you know, that's when I feel like all the brands just started making the mini wrapped candies, the fun size, you know, Snicker bars or Reese's cups or the little two pack of Starbursts. And that's what we got. And then it also made
no
it
black
fun
licorice.
Because
no gross, black no. licorice.
No. Ugh. If you're a black licorice fan, comment below, because I find very few actual black licorice fans nowadays.
And I want to know what personality trait likes that black licorice. So please.
That's crazy. Gosh.
Yeah.
Oh. So Shawn, I have to think about it because I feel like you were, but like, I know Halloween people like to prank and mess around. And did you, Did you do any of that? Were you that person?
I cannot confirm or deny, but there may have been some eggs thrown or some rope-a-dope, the fake pulling of the rope, or some bad jokes told by a friend of mine. Certainly, I wouldn't do that. But
Never. Never you. Bit.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh.
You know, one of the things we always did, too, is, we went for the massive haul of candy. It was, you would have cavities for years off of our haul.
Sure.
So did you guys carry the old pumpkin basket, or was it a pillowcase?
We definitely had the plastic pumpkin looking thing with the handle, and it was a jack-o'-lantern. Yeah. And we definitely had it. But there were plenty of times where when it would get full, we'd maybe make a pit stop at home if we went around the neighborhood and we'd dump it out and go back out. But definitely had the plastic pumpkin for sure. Pretty sure they're still down in my parents' basement.
Yeah, we made the pillowcase into like Santa's backpack, holiday. So we were not coming back without a full load. So
never. Oh gosh.
Definitely needed. And hopefully you didn't get mom's lacy pillowcase and it made you look odd. So,
just a plain white one was good
to
go. Right.
That's right.
Exactly. Perfect.
So did you guys have themed houses?
Not that much. I know when there was maybe one or two houses that would make you go in and be like, oh, close your eyes and feel what's in this bowl and tell me what it is. But those were usually the older couples that lived in our neighborhoods that probably started doing it when it was a really popular thing and just kept doing it.
Yeah.
But most people, you go up, you tell your joke, you pick your candy and you're on your way. So it was never a big pit stop. I think we were also warned by our parents that you never know what someone's going to do. So not to go necessarily into their house if you can help it, even if they invite you in. And I think that was a big thing I've noticed is as the years have gone on, safety's obviously become a really big issue. Why, don't go in their houses. Always had a parent supervising and with us when we were walking. Mm. Even if we're in a group and I was older, there was always a parent, don't eat the homemade candies. I think safety was such a big deal when I was trick or treating. And I think it's even more so now.
Yeah.
On top of it, which is crazy.
I think that leads into the whole trunk or treat for sure. I mean,
absolutely.
I know that our kids are now in their approaching, one in their 20s and one approaching 20s, that when they were little, the trunk or treat had just begun.
Exactly.
As they were phasing out of Halloween. And now it seems like that's almost a norm for churches and other organizations. And so.
Right. Yeah. It's definitely safer just to have it be in a public area and go get all your stuff. Yeah. And then
just not as fun. Just not as fun.
It's not the same, Yeah, everybody wants that classic Halloween experience, but what can you do?
Well, and certainly this year we'll see what it experienced. I know I've seen a lot of videos of creative dispensing machines with PVC pipes and various other contraptions that are launching candy and stuff to make it a little bit more safe. Hopefully we can don our gloves and our masks and still participate and have some fun with it.
Right.
I know it's definitely a challenge in the environment today.
Yeah. So with that, those were all my questions. Did you have anything else?
No, I'm super stoked. I'll give out my address if anybody has any bit of honey that they want to drop off.
I'll take the Reese's peanut butter cups. Thanks so much.
So we hope everybody has a safe and enjoyable Halloween. And we certainly look forward to it. Thank you.
All righty. We'll see you guys next time. Be safe out there and have a great holiday. Bye.
Yay. See ya.